Are you getting dizzy? Are you dizzy? Ah. If you're not dizzy, I'm dizzy. Let's do this thing.
When you get that prize money, you pay me, because that's how it works.
I love you, Quitter.
Oh, I didn't have time to fix everything.
Hey. Let's get that car.
Hi there. Greetings, viewers. Eric the Car Guy here.
Hello, Eric the Car Guy viewer.
Greetings, viewers.
Now I need my ski mask.
Greetings, viewers. Torque converters. What they do and how they work. Today on Eric the Car Guy.
Here we have a torque converter. A torque converter is only found on an automatic transmission. Manual transmissions do not use torque converters.
Eric the Car Guy here. Today we are going to cover the basic parts of an engine. Something that's been bugging me ever since I got this Subaru is that I've had a hesitation when I first hit the gas from a dead stop taking off down the road. I am Eric the Car Guy, back again with hopefully some more useful information for you. In fact, I know this is useful information because you probably requested this video a lot since I started doing this. You've wanted to know this. And that is, how do I change the brake fluid in my car? And welcome to another episode of Eric the Car Guy. Today I've got a little quick tip for you. You ever have trouble getting those screws out of those Honda rotors to try to get the rotor off to change it or machine it or anything like that? I've got a tip for you. Come on down. I said come on. I am Eric the Car Guy and this is Fat R number 32.
And welcome to Fat R number 29.
Hello everyone, and welcome to this week's Fat R. And for those of you not familiar with what Fat R is, it is Fridays at the Red Line. So now I'm going to make a really preachy one. And we're going to call this one, Don't Make My Life More Difficult. What I mean when I say that is behind me is a 2000 Accord. Now, this 2000 Accord has over 200,000 miles on it. And at one time, it was a really, really nice car.
We have to do this again when we go to leave the AutoZone?
Not once it gets... Not once. Bet that works.
So how much fuel are you buying today, sir?
$5.
$5? Yeah. Meanwhile, the ambulance is calling the police.
We're being chased by a big blue piece.
My wife's in that ambulance. She's having my baby.
Oh my God! This is the only car I have. I put together this video a couple years ago for a friend of mine. We were kind of a little tongue-in-cheek having fun with his little truck. So you can think less of me if you want, but it's just part of my sense of humor. Hope you enjoy it.
So I'm walking through the parking lot and I see this really big man driving this really scary looking truck. And I walk up to him and I say, hey, can I have a ride? And he says, no, I don't think you need a ride. I'm trying to find a place to park my big scary truck. And I looked over and he was parking his truck on top of this other truck. It's just like, why are you doing this? This isn't right. You shouldn't be parking your truck on somebody else's truck. And he looked at me and he said, you know what? You're right. I'm going to go over there and crawl up that pole. I said, crawl up the pole? What do you mean crawl up the pole? I got all excited because he's talking about taking his truck and crawling up a pole, but sure enough, he went over to this pole in this parking lot and he started driving his truck right up this pole, and I couldn't believe it. I looked over and I was like, wow. So I was looking at his truck, it was crawling up this pole, and I saw he had this sweet little metal basket that he had made and put on the back of it. I just thought that was the cutest thing. But anyway, after he crawled up this pole, he said, take a picture. So I did, and I took this picture. Isn't it really kind of cool how he says it's all articulated and stuff? But anyway, he was so proud that he had taken his truck and crawled up this pole. I had to say hello, and, you know, then I had to be on my way because I had places to be, and I couldn't hang around and watch him play with his truck anymore. So I said goodbye, and he said goodbye, and that's the story of pole crawling. Well, you all have a very good day. Thank you. Bye.
I thought I would give you a little bit of behind the scenes. A lot of you probably wonder what I do besides fix cars. Well, making videos is a lot of what I do, and I do that here in my edit suite. Nothing really fancy. It might look fancier than it is, but, you know, this is what works. So why don't I just walk you through what it is that I do to make these Eric the Car Guy videos, in case some of you are interested. Okay, I use Final Cut Pro. This is the interface here. I use version 7. There's a newer version out that I just have yet to adopt. But I'm about to edit one on an Element check engine light. So I've got two monitors. I use a Mac Pro from like 2007. And then this guy here is the important guy. This is like it's a RAID setup. It has like all the footage for Eric the Car Guy in it. If I'm doing voiceovers, I've got this boom mic and a mixer that runs things into the computer. But I also use this trackball because I've actually found that it makes my wrist hurt if I use just a regular mouse, but not so much with the trackball. But this is the basic setup. And this is where the camera that I'm holding right now would go to put the footage into the computer. Here's one of the cameras I use. It's a Sony HDR SR11. I put wide-angle lenses on them, work as lens protectors, and, you know, they give a wider point of view. It helps tremendously. They're hard drive cameras, so I just basically load them onto this and load the footage into the computer.
Oi!
Oi!
Oi! Oi! You got one of them fancy version picture cameras.
I know, it's kind of cool.
My name's Dale Mark. I'm from Reynoldsburg, Ohio, not an hour and a half from here. And I just started on YouTube watching videos from Eric because I was wanting to work on my car, and I decided to visit his site. And I grew to really identify with, you know, the issues of working on a car and all the little tricks you can do. And having worked on cars here and there as a do-it-yourselfer, I just really appreciated what he was doing. And that's just a great opportunity to be here and meet with Eric. And I'm sure he's helped a lot of people save money. So really appreciate being here today. Hey, this is the Meetup 2012, and I'm glad to be part of it.
My name's Tom DeCeylon. I live in New Jersey, as you can see from this place. I've been following Eric on YouTube ever since he came out, so I think 3 or 4 years. Very loyal fan. I always gave his support to the comments. He's definitely my idol. Inspired me to do my own work on the car, trial and error. Not easy, but I still did it. And I am really honored to be here today. The 12, 13 hours in rain and fog didn't even bother me at all coming out here.
thank you. Learned quite a few things from you, and I actually got a lead technician promotion about 6 months ago. I think I owe you a big thank you for that. So, my pleasure driving all the way out here. It's about 12 hours. Wouldn't have missed it for the world. Plan on doing this as many times as we possibly can. So, thanks.
So, how was the meetup?
Great.
And awesome. What did we do? We fixed the Honda transmission.
Yeah.
Kind of.
No, sort of. No. It was a total fail.
Kind of, sort of.
But it was
no,
fun.
We didn't.
Like, all these people, like, helped me. Wish you were here, but, you know, you're not. But next year, there will be a next year, and we'll have more potato salad. Then hopefully nobody gets sick from eating.
Not that anybody did this year.
So what do we close with, guys?
Stay safe, have fun.
Yeah, there you go.
Of course. Be safe, have fun.
Stay dirty.
Stay dirty.
And stay dirty. So, see you next time. Bye! Meetup 2012! So awesome! So awesome!